Dear students, this is a continuation of previous lecture on discussion of choice of number of poles. And in first part, already we have discussed how choice of number of poles are done depending upon frequency of flux reversal, then weight of iron parts in yoke area, armature core area, and how overall diameter of machine gets affected depending upon number of poles. Okay, now let us discuss remaining four factors like weight of copper in both armature and field section, then what happens to length of commutator based on number of poles, then what happens to labor charges, then flashover and distortion of field form. Okay, already these two factors I have discussed. Now let us move on to third parameter, that is weight of copper. Okay, here we are going to study what is effect of choice of number of poles on weight of copper required for armature as well as field section. Okay, and before we are going to discuss about how there is change in volume of copper required for armature and field section depending upon number of poles, let us see first what is meaning of active copper or active portion of conductor and inactive portion of conductors. Okay, the portion of conductors responsible for EMF production in generators or torque production in motors is called active portion of conductor. And this particular portion of conductor will be embedded in slots, and the portion of conductor in the overhang which just provides connection between active portion of conductor and doesn't take any part in energy conversion process, and this is called inactive copper or inactive portion of conductors. Say, by seeing this figure you will understand what is active copper and what is inactive copper. Here the conductor which is exactly placed in slot and which take active part in energy conversion, that is active copper, and copper which is used in overhang or in the outhang just to make the connection between two conductors beyond this active length, that is called inactive copper. And this ratio of inactive conductor material to active conductor material will decide cost of the machine. Okay, and here depending upon number of poles used to design, this outhang which is inactive copper material requirement will change. So here this is for two pole machine, and this image shows four pole machine, and in case of two pole machine, length of inactive copper compared to length of inactive copper for four pole, for two pole it is more and for four pole it is less. And depending upon length of this outhang and depending upon number of poles, overall length of machine will change. Whenever number of poles are less, definitely outhang will be more, and with this outhang length of machine for two pole is more than four pole, because here overhang portion is less. This is overall length and this is actually active length, and overall length depends upon active length of conductor embedded in the slot and outhang. Okay, so here cost of machine is less for the machine which has ratio inactive to inactive conductor material to active conductor material less. Okay, so let us discuss what is effect of inactive copper on weight of copper material required depending upon type of number of poles. So let us consider effect of this inactive copper. You know, diameter of machine remains constant depending upon pole pitch, because diameter of machine remains constant and therefore pole pitch varies inversely as the number of poles as per this equation 2 equal to pi d by b. Right? If diameter of machine is kept constant, then pole pitch depends upon number of poles and these are inversely related. And length of conductor in overhang decreases with increase in number of poles. Just now I explained. Okay. Then, because of this length of conductor in overhang, less for higher number of poles, then weight of inactive copper varies inversely as the number of poles. As length of inactive copper decreases due to increase in number of poles, definitely weight of inactive copper will be less for large number of poles. This is advantage. Then comparing two machines, the amount of copper used in overhang of two pole machine is greater than that of four pole machine. Okay, because from this figure it is clear that outhang, that is distance through which overhang projects outside the core, is more in case of two pole machine. Definitely it will give larger overlength for the machine. Hence increase in number of poles reduces weight of copper in armature and at the same time reduces outhang of the winding, so that overall length of the machine decreases. So increase in number of poles will reduce requirement of copper in armature section. Same time, reduction in overhang due to large number of poles will reduce overall length of the machine. Okay. Then coming to field copper, you know the field MMA per core varies inversely as the number of poles. And let us consider case of two machines which have different pole numbers, like two pole and four poles. Okay. If number of poles are increased, then definitely field MMA per pole will reduce. And because of that, area of cross section of each pole in case of two pole machine will be two times the four pole. It is double, because flux per field MMA per pole is less for four pole machine compared to two pole machine. Hence two pole machine requires more cross sectional area to handle that flux flow compared to four pole machine. So here this image shows what happens to length of mean turn with increase in number of poles. This is for two pole and this is for four pole machine. Definitely a length of mean turn required for two pole machine is more than four pole machine. Okay. As field MMA per pole in case of two pole machine is double that of four pole machine, then mean length of turn is greater in case of two pole machine. As shown in this figure, length of mean turn is more because field section is more. So here, because of this, weight of field copper is more in case of two pole machine. Therefore, total weight of field copper decreases with increase in number of poles. If number of poles are increased, depending upon field MMA per pole, requirement of field copper change, and hence total weight of field copper decreases with increase in number of poles. Okay. Then what happens to field winding resistance and field copper loss? Same time, what happens to area of field conductors depending upon this flux field MMA per pole? See here, as mean length of field turn decreases due to large number of poles, definitely field winding resistance decreases with increase in number of poles. And same time, field copper loss becomes smaller, therefore small loss, if losses are small, definitely area of field conductors required will be less, because field copper loss will be less due to increase in number of poles. Okay. Thus, the weight of copper of both armature and field winding decreases with increase in number of poles. If number of poles are increased, then requirement of copper will be less for both armature as well as field sections. Okay. Then coming to fourth parameter, that is length of commutator. The number of brush arms employed is equal to number of poles in case of machines with lap wound armature. But usually in case of wave wound, number of parallel paths are two and only two brush arms can be considered. But usually even in case of wave winding machine, for large capacity machines, brush arm provided are equal to number of poles. Okay, here let us consider two lap wound machines for with different pole numbers. Type of winding is lap winding, but let us discuss with different pole numbers what happens to length of commutator. Okay, for two pole machine, there will be two brush arms in machine. Because of two brush arms, current per parallel path is Iz equal to Ia by 2. Since there are two parallel paths meeting at each brush arm, the current in each brush arm Ib is as Iz equal to Ia by 2, therefore Ib equal to Ia. So this image shows for two pole machine, only two brushes are used and current in each brush arm is Ia by 2. Then what happens to four pole machine? In case of four pole machine, there will be four parallel paths and current in each parallel path Iz is Ia by 4. Therefore, current in each brush arm Ib is 2Iz, which is equal to Ia by 2. Therefore, current in each brush arm for poles, for four pole is half of two pole. Here, current per brush arm is less for four pole machine compared to two pole machines here. This is Ia, then Ib equal to Ia by 2. Here Ib equal to Ia. See, generally current is collected by each brush arm varies inversely as number of poles. If number of poles are more, then current per brush arm will be less. So because of this, whatever area of brush required, that can be reduced with large number of poles. Right, and what happens to length of brush? Definitely length of brush required in each brush arm is reduced with increase in number of poles. Okay, then what is the conclusion? So here there is reduction in length of commutator and incidentally results in reduction of overall length of the machine. Total length of machine includes length, active length of conductor, then commutator which is attached to that armature part. Okay, if length of brush or size of brush decrease due to large number of poles, definitely overall length of the machine decreases. Okay, coming to labor charges, here let us consider EM equation for DC machine, E equal to 5Z divided by A. Since P5 is assumed to be constant, E is proportional to Z divided by A. From this, depending upon number of parallel paths for lap winding, in case of lap winding A equal to P, right? With this, E is proportional to Zn divided by P, and if you consider A equal to P, then therefore Z is proportional to EP divided by N. Depending upon number of poles, if large number of poles are used, number of conductors will be more and definitely that will increase labor charges in case of armature coils. Okay, then coming to field coils, again here also, if number of poles are more, more number of poles need assembling, insulation as well as winding in field coils also. Therefore, labor charges will increase as number of poles are increased. Then coming to flashover, what happens to flashover? This very important factor when deciding the number of poles. If large number of poles are used, there is increase in danger of flashover between two adjacent brush, and number of brush arms is equal to number of poles. For same diameter of commutator, the distance between adjacent brush arms decrease as the pole is increased. Hence, there is increase in possibility of flashover between adjacent brush arms. How this can be, this problem can be avoided by increasing length of diameter of commutator. Then coming to field form, armature mm per pole varies inversely with number of poles. Okay, Hence, distortion of flux will be there, and that causes commutation problems.